welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's special event, the Snow Bunnies Tournament, here live from Sydney, Australia. A real surprise bag to start off the year for Whassup Wrestling, as eight lovely VixXxens here within Whassup Wrestling will be challenging each other for the right to basically call themselves the Queen Snow Bunny. First coming down to the ring, we have Busty Buffy St.Claire, who's not as successful as she would have liked to be. Back at what was the last event? Christmas Chaos. It has been a while. And Dusty Rhodes tournament coming in between. AJ Smith coming out of Christmas Chaos, winning the VixXxen's title in that 1-on-3 handicap encounter. Busty now having a chance to basically turn things around for her little group. We start here tonight as the surprise bag brings us a Hell in a Cell to start the night. That's exactly what we can expect from this tournament here. Let's see who's been drawn as her opponent. And it sounds like it's Rydel Everett. Everett of the Glow Girls running through a situation with the Evil Girls. Luckily for her, none of them are competing in this tournament. Rydel, of course, dressed like she just came right off the slopes. The wild slopes of Australia, of course. I'm sure they have slopes somewhere. We just haven't seen them. They're hiding them somewhere, ladies and gentlemen. Find them. Of course, we've got Ida and Suko losing out in that matchup against Betsy Miller, and then the Glow Girls losing in that 2-on-3 match via countout due to outside forces. I'm not quite certain what those were about, but either way, the Evil Girls now holding a 2-victory hold over the Glow Girls. That doesn't warrant the Evil Girls a shot at Ida's Women's Championship. Who knows what will. For now, we have Rydel, taking on Busty in this opening contest. Rydel, no stranger to tournament situations, having actually won the women's tag team tournament. And gotten fairly far into the Queen of the Ring tournament back in June. They're now falling immediate prey to Busty's heinous attacks. His heinous style here in this Hell in a Cell. As usual, we all know that the referee firmly in the pocket. And now, Rydel finally coming back, slingshotting, busting off the top rope. It's a little leg drop down across Busty's throat. A nice little kick there by Rydel. Bit too far, but Rydel's still going to make the effort. And certainly pays for it as Busty comes back. Dropkick to the back, taking out Rydel. The referee watches on. Rydel brought up to a knee and now just punched down. Busty putting out all of her frustrations on this former tag team champion. One half of the women's tag team champions later on tonight. And we just don't know when. And Rydel fighting back. Busty apparently going for a DDT. Spent too much time kind of preening there. Rydel coming around. Hurricane Rana. Referee hops out of the way. Very smart of him not wanting to be there when the collision happens. Busty nearly sent over the top rope there with that back body drop. I'm sorry, back drop. Finding some comfort in the corner, but no. Yes, Busty fighting back. Riley couldn't resist. Now, Riley's back slammed hard into the steel cage. And the fight being taking place on the outside. Busty flipping off, and now knee to the groin. Luckily, Busty not using the side of the cage too much there. Kick to the face, and now here comes the cover, center of the ring, and Busty nearly busting out of this one. So he's really thinking that this one will be over soon enough. Single suplex. Double suplex. Will this be it? The trifecta, and trifecta lands in the bridge. Two, and no. Riley just manages to get the shoulder up, but the damage may have been done. Riley fighting back on instinct now. She's got a lot of ground to cover. She wants to come out of this one. And they start with a split-legged moonsault. And now the cover. Here we go! One, two, and no! Kick out with some light authority there by Busty. Riley now with another leg drop. Sure, Ida is watching this one, praying for her partner. Here we go, Mount Everett. Two. No! Busty with the shoulder up. What's Riley doing now? Riley on the outside waiting for Busty to come up. Springboard! Springboard crossbody! Misses with the double axe handle and face crusher from behind from Busty. Riley rolling out of the ring to safety. Busty just watching on from inside. Trying to regain something, but no. Pinning elimination and just a two count, but I didn't see a kick out. And in fact, it just sort of stopped. The two just stared at each other for a bit. By the way, Busty is still continuing on this assault. Hitting the ropes and elbow drop. Busty on that. What's Busty going for here? Busty with a sledgehammer. Busty with a sledgehammer. Nearly cracking it down on Riley's face. Riley managing to wrestle it free. She's not going to use it herself. She will, however, use the turnbuckle pad. Once again, Busty pulling Riley out, now going for the cover. A lot of pressure on the side of that, on the side of the face. And Busty wiping away the sweat. Now just choking the life out of Riley. When Busty and Tina first came in, the first thing we ever said was how rough the competitors that those two were, and Busty is certainly showing it. Another split-legged moonsault. Riley again going for the cover. This could be it. Riley advancing to the semifinals. And yes, Riley advances. Riley surviving this one. She'll have some time to recover. but who will be her opponent? So split legged moonsault and Mount Everett, center of the ring. But unfortunately, it was not enough. And there we see this cover again. Will we see the kick out? And no, there was no kick out until after what would have been the three. Not certain what the referee was doing there. Anyway, it is Riley Everett victorious here, moving on in this tournament. And did anyone out there say no holds barred against Queen Amazonia? Certainly do not pity the woman who will be facing off against Queen Amazonia in a no-holds-barred matchup. Amazonia just plucking on a pair of rabbit ears. You see a little buddy tail, so at least she's come in here with the spirit of the tournament. Suspect that it was really more so Stephanie McMahon who set that up. Really just a catchy joke. What is this? What is this, ladies and gentlemen? Is she finally back? We haven't seen her since October. And it is! Roxy Stevenson has come back. The last time we saw her, she was being persuaded by Lady Chaos to join her side. I suppose now, looking back on it, Lady Chaos was in fact not really talking to Roxy. Roxy was just there in the ring with her. You know that Lady Chaos's attention was drawn more towards Samantha Hayes there of Cyclone. AKA Cyclone, sorry. I don't know the name of Samantha, Darkstar. Roxy finally back here in Whassup Wrestling. Grand return at the Snowbunny tournament, but I really don't like her chances. Yes, she is a former VixXxen's champion, but still. This is Queen Amazonia, the enforcer of the council. Single-handedly won out the women's tag team titles against two of the harem members. Well, Roxy will have to fight her on her own. And here we go, Amazonia coming in, DDTing Roxy. Roxy just sort of just almost looked like she was accepting it of sorts. The shoulder claw, as I said, this is a no-holds-barred contest. It certainly favors Amazonia, allowing her to do whatever she wants in order to win, and it looks like she's just doing that. Not going for a cover. Will this be... No! As I said, was this going to be a squash match of sorts, but no, Roxy kicking out, but still, nothing back from Roxy. Perhaps far, far too much ring rust for the dancing queen here of Whassup Wrestling. And launched right off the apron. Roxy finally fighting back, but the damage may have already been done. Just like with Riley, who had a long mountain to climb, Roxy may surprise everyone by doing just that. Utilize everything she can, including the ring post and her kicking abilities here and the crowd support. It's really about the only way that she could equal herself up to the awesome power and might of Amazonia. Roxy was trying for a German suplex, getting thrown over the ropes, now thrown back into the ring with brutal authority. So now burying that knee to the Amazonia's face. Amazonia is certainly the favorite to win this one now. She's got to be, no matter who else is in this tournament. Roxy still fighting back. Roxy, tons of kicks. Now she's poised, ready, infusing the catnip. Catch me out, back of the head. She could be advancing, facing Riley, no. So many fans are hoping that Roxy comes out of here victorious. Not just because it would put a crawl on the side of Stephanie McMahon and the council, but to see Roxy and Riley, the two dancingest VixXxens here in Whassup Wrestling, going at it. What kind of contest could they come up with? And Roxy again, burying that knee into Amazonia's face. Roxy doing everything she can to take Amazonia down and keep her down. Sending her up. And top rope arm drag. Punch to the face, turning Amazonia around, and Roxy doing surprise. Look, what is this? Is this Alexa Bliss? Roxy now waiting for. No! Seems like they were just going to play it, and Amazonia was just about coming in behind, but Roxy catching her, but no, still Amazonia now just tossing Roxy around. Referee still waiting to, just watching for Alexa. Really, this is definitely the work of Stephanie McMahon. So I doubt that Alexa Bliss's chances of joining in with the council are there anymore. Amazonia thinks that she's done enough, at least for now, to grab herself a weapon. And if Amazonia wasn't dangerous on her own, Amazonia with a bat, just clonking it across the forehead of Roxy Stevenson. Amazonia's power behind that swing with Roxy right back up. Thankfully, her brain is not used for much. Now this whole thing has just changed around. What the hell is Bailey doing? Bailey's here, but who is she here for? Looks like she might be here on behalf of Roxy. This is a no-holds-barred matchup. Now Amazonia just holding her steady. Bailey just kind of sick and tired of the council. Referee trying to keep her from doing any more. And Bailey to belly. And Roxy. Roxy was down and up during all of it. And now she's going to come for the cover. Two. And no, just a two count. Roxy unable to take advantage of the Bailey to belly. But perhaps it's enough. It may be enough for the cat's meow. Infuse the catnip. The kick. And now the cover. And here we go. One, two, and no. Amazonia again kicking out. The Survivor Series all over again. Bailey is still here. Perhaps she can come in and give more assistance. Hard shot to the face. And now, no. Amazonia tripping up Roxy's leg. Bailey still having trouble in the back. We've seen that multiple times before. And now the torture rack. But in comes Bailey. And Roxy taps out. Amazonia advances. But again, what was Bailey doing here? Busty putting up one hell of a fight. There we see the infusing catnip and the kick, not to the back of the head, but to the back of the shoulder. And we see the counter from there, the belly to belly. And Amazonia, just at that moment, Roxy getting to her feet. This may have been premeditated. We see the second one, and there we see it. Oh, catching the lower back, perhaps sliding up, getting Amazonia in the head, but either way, it was not enough. The torture rack sends Amazonia to the semifinals against Riley Everett. And unfortunately, Roxy was unable to gain a victory over Amazonia. Perhaps what chance does Riley have? See in the first semi-final, ladies and gentlemen, but we still have two quarterfinals to go. Whassup Wrestling is brought to you by Snacky S'mores. Eat Snacky S'mores. Quarterfinal, and what a last match that was. Looks like this perhaps coming out, and then Bailey making her Whassup Wrestling debut. There we will see, and now Kitty reverting back to her original attire, just with a couple of additions here to her name. Make her hair flow out for tonight's tournament. Will be the second representative of the council. We saw Queen Amazonia advancing to the semifinals, where she'll be facing off against Riley Everett. Kitty be joining her in the second set of semifinals. The council finally. Well, what a match that would be. Not sure if that's the case, Kitty would have been just told to lie down and accept Amazonia as the victor. And it sounds like it's going to be Catherine Neville here. This submission matchup, and oh. Oh dear. Oh, Catherine. Catherine trying to make it work. I mean, it's definitely her under there. Perhaps this is more punishment. No, sorry, Catherine. It's just too silly. Yes, perhaps this is punishment for just trying to stand in for her friend. In Christmas chaos, but well, perhaps Catherine really thinks that the rabbit mask does it? But no, with the cat suit, no. It really just does not suit her. And what a pushback by Catherine. Let's just try and focus on the contest here. That's where Catherine's attention is going. Even competing in those cat paw gloves. And this is what happens when you challenge the general manager of Whassup Wrestling. Now, overhead belly-to-belly by Kitty. We've seen the career of Kitty ebb and flow in a multitude of ways. Now, from a challenger against the council to becoming the council's cheerleader, lasting a long enough while in matches to going 5 seconds against Riley Everett. Kitty really is the wild card here of the VixXxen's division. Now Catherine having a hold of Kitty's arm, putting in a fair deal of torque. Seen any sign of Summer Holly Madison since she was expelled by the council. Still, Catherine continuing on the fight against the council. Unfortunately, despite the amount of people who have fought against the council is still here to be fought against. Getting on top, and now Catherine turning things around on top, slamming Kitty down. And this is a submission matchup, in case I didn't mention it before. This match may favor more Catherine in this one, but Kitty was in the council back when Spice was a member. She may have been taught a thing or two in such a scenario. For such scenarios. Such as this, the camel clutch. And was Kitty just grabbing hold of Catherine's cheekbones there? She may have been. And Kitty fighting back, headbutt. But Catherine just kind of stands through it, and now chopping suplex, taking her down. Much padding that Stu provides. Well, at least comes with some knee pads. You can see the puffiness there. Now Catherine. Catherine with the arm bar. Catherine trying for it, but no. Kitty managing to fight back. Snap suplex there by Kitty. Now bitch maker to Kitty for Catherine Neville. And now once again with that iron bar, surprised Catherine didn't just tap out of embarrassment coming up in this one. There clearly done. Kitty may see it and make a keep up the effort on the arms. Catherine just not able to get Kitty all the way up for that slingshot. Now single arm crab, or single leg crab. Sorry. Kitty managing to turn things around there. Elbow to the face. Arm drag taking Kitty down. Again, just dropping your center of the ring. Kitty now finally fighting back, not letting Catherine get in too much and trying for the belly. No, headlock takedown. Kitty showing a bit of frustration there, and Catherine taking advantage and now taking a break. Hard shot and final nail. But this is not for pinfalls. This is for submissions. And now Catherine again going for that single leg crab. And that's it. It's enough. Catherine advances. Much to her dismay, she'll have to come back out in the rabbit mask. Still shot with a headbutt there by Kitty. Now that trapping suplex. Kitty is a fierce fighter, but she just does not have the record to prove it. And as we see, it's a bitch maker. Taking Catherine down, but it is the single leg crab in the end. It grants Catherine her victory. And we're seeing it again from more a better perspective. Kitty Penny tapping out, and now Catherine moving on to the semifinals. But who will she be facing? And now Catherine still has to wear something of a smile here. Don't forget your rabbit mask. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, reminding you once again, we are coming to you live from Sydney, Australia. And here she comes, one half of the Women's Tag Team Champions, already dressed for this tournament. Dressed for this tournament for the past few months. It's a debut being brought in by Paige alongside Crystal Blake. Maloney, the 2022 Queen. The Miss Money in the Bank, sorry, casting her briefcase through Paige for a title shot at the tag team titles against the Council, winning that matchup alongside Crystal Blake at Christmas Chaos, entering the new year as Women's Tag Team Champion, and perhaps stepping forth into it as the Miss Snowbunny, as if that was going to mean anything aside from honoring bragging rights. This is just like the Dusty Rhodes tournament. It is all about bragging rights here, ladies and gentlemen. There are no new titles coming in. We've had enough. Lastly, it seems we have Honey Rydel, thankfully coming down to the ring on her own. A late Christmas gift. Goddess Anya, allowing Honey to make her grand entrance on her own. Saw before with Sasha Banks and with Honey. Honey maybe just letting up on the girls. We'll see how long that lasts going into 2023. Here in Whassup Wrestling. That flower just briefly in display. Now Harper Maloney taking on Honey Rydel. It is current Women's Tag Team Champion versus former Women's Tag Team Champion. Honey Rydel, the second to last woman eliminated in that Survivor Series matchup against the Council, putting up one hell of a fight against Queen Amazonia. Perhaps if she's victorious here and against Catherine Neville, she might have her opportunity at some revenge. But it is a long road for her to go. That's two matches, and Amazonia is already set for the first semifinal and perhaps finals. She said she is the odds-on favorite here. I suppose we should never count out either of these women, or even Riley Everett. And Harper just using her body as a weapon, tossing herself off the top rope, colliding with Honey, and now slow motion lifting her up, and Honey managing to counter out of that. Pushing her back down, going for the cover. Just a one count. A DDT right on Stephanie's face. Fighting back. Honey again squirming free. Honey definitely a seasoned competitor here in Whassup Wrestling. Has just shown her a lot. Honey is surrounded by other seasoned individuals such as Sasha Banks, Atsuko Mitsusaka, and Katie Klein inside of the harem. Together with their goddess, they seem to help each other, and it seems to be working. Is going non-stop now, coming off the top neckbreaker there. Maloney just immediately bringing Harper up to her feet, up onto her shoulders, and off the top rope. But again, Maloney just giving Harper no chance for a break. No pause, just keeping right on top of her. Maloney keeping a slow pace, not running around the ring. Maintaining her stamina, making Harper do all the running. Now, oh! Dropping Harper right off the top rope there. Now, spinning heel kick. Honey taking a moment there. That's little Honey there. Gloating to the crowd and watching Harper try and crawl away, but to no avail, Honey catching hold of her. And now Honey glazed. Honey just rushing right through Harper, and that could be it. Yes, just a dominant display by Honey Rydel. Perhaps she does have Queen Amazonia on the mind. Earlier in the match, just perhaps setting things up. There's a spinning heel kick. Setting her up and just nailing her with Honey Glazed. Harper not seeing where any of that came from. Now Honey Rydel advancing to the semi-final. She'll be taking on Catherine Neville. Honey certainly picked a winner when she convinced Honey to join. Everett to take on Queen Amazonia. They were victorious over Busty, Buffy, St.Claire earlier tonight. That Hell in a Cell. Queen Amazonia was victorious over Roxy Stevens just moments ago. Contest that was Alexa Bliss. Theme was playing there, and it seemed like she was going to come out and assault Roxy. And we have Amazonia managed to set up by Stephanie in the back. But Bailey seems to be having enough. Here we go. I mean, here we are in Sydney, Australia. She had a reason to be here otherwise. It was the way that Roxy got up right after the Bailey to belly. And we just clear that. Meditated, but since I don't know who she was facing until the match began, either way, just now Riley's turn to step up to the plate to take on Queen Amazonia. We'll see if she can get the job done and advance into the finals. Snowbunny gear. Bunny ears, the bunny tail. She's got it down pat, that's for sure. This contest will be a falls count anywhere contest. So we'll see where this one ends up. For this one. Unfortunately, Oops. Amazonia gets hold of her fast. Riley trying to go for a kick, but just was not fast enough for Amazonia to catch hold of her. And again, Amazonia just won't even complete the suplex. He'll just toss away Riley like she were nothing. And up on the shoulders already with the torture rack. This one could be over already, and no. Riley countering out. Perhaps just knowing that she could then give her a better chance later on. Riley slowly coming up to her feet and knockout punch. This can't be over now. Kick out, Riley. Kick out. 2, 3. Amazonia just obliterating Riley. Advancing to the finals. Like we said, she is the odds-on favorite here. Amazonia's own entrance longer than this contest. And then we see it again, just a straight shot. Riley falling immediate prey to that one. And there we go. Amazonia victorious. It'll be Amazonia in the finals against either Catherine Neville or Honey Rydel. Both of whom have a personal interest in facing this woman, and who will get the opportunity? We'll soon find out, ladies and gentlemen. We are ready for our second semi-final contest here in Snowbunny's tournament. Catherine Steed coming back out with that rabbit mask. I guess she's just accepting it. Trying to make it work. She's very good with some of the things she does, typically with her entrance maneuvering. And here's one right here. Exactly the most pleasant of rabbits. Teleporting rabbit. So this was meant to be a punishment, but yes. Perhaps we'll see this again sometime in the future. Catherine Neville. Maybe not. Never quite know. Especially when it comes to the resident cyber goth in Catherine Neville, and now we await the arrival of the other semi-finalist, Honey Rydel. Both these women certainly have a score to settle with their own with Queen Amazonia. Catherine Neville seems to have a fight against the Council, while Honey would like to be able to get some revenge for Survivor Series, which was the second to last one eliminated there by Amazonia herself, so to set that record straight, certainly an incentive for Honey. Like I said, Catherine is here fighting on behalf of Summer Holly Madison, who was originally booked for this tournament, but obviously is bowed out due to outside circumstances that we're just not aware of. Cowardice, but we'll see. And here we go, Catherine Neville, Honey Rydel. Set to go one-on-one, low drop kick to the ankle there by Catherine. Didn't state this during the intro, but this match is set as an extreme rules contest. And Honey's just whipping Catherine around. The backdrop near the ropes there. And some straight shots and a DDT. DDT to Catherine Neville. Sunny calls her up. Little rope. Neck breaker there, center of the ring. And Honey loosening herself up for this one. She's far fresher than Catherine Neville would be. Neckbreaker. Seems she's got a chosen target. Shining Wizard back in the head kick. Honey's just stalking her prey. Now just lounging. Total disrespect to Catherine Neville here. And Catherine didn't even see a thing. She did see the shoulder. Now Catherine, outside of the ring, taking advantage of this Extreme Rules contest. Pull out a baseball bat and just clocking Honey between the eyes there. Shades of Amazonia on Roxy earlier tonight. Knocking over some chairs. Taking out the special guest there. I suppose they feel safe enough to sit down, even though the competition is going right beside them. And then coming back in after tossing Catherine towards the ring post. I think Catherine was smart enough to trip him. What was that? Saw Honey just sort of glitching out there for a little bit. Not certain what that was all about, but now Catherine with a spinning kick, knocking the baseball bat out of Honey's grip. I know that there's been some problems within the VixXxen's set or roster. And we don't mean personal problems, we mean problems of the glitchy nature. They only ever seem to affect the VixXxen's here at Whassup Wrestling. Charles Manson really needs to get up there and find out what's going on. Catherine Neville on the outside. Unfortunately, that's not an apron you can get a weapon out of. At least we haven't seen it done thus far. And Honey doing a little dance, showing that she's all right. Perhaps sending a message to her goddess that she's willing to continue fighting. Now with the baseball bat, the fight continues. Catherine Neville having it. As it was knocked out of her hand, and now Honey's face first into the ring post. Catherine Neville. Kick. And a running kick. And Honey sent running and just glitches in behind Catherine. Catherine just not certain what was going on there. Should remind that this match is not a falls count anywhere contest. They both have to get back into the ring at some point in order to successfully obtain a pinfall. Finally, Catherine thrown into the ring. After all that assault, will it be enough? And no, only worth a one count. And he's prepping for something here. Shining Wizard, another one. Back of Catherine's head. Catherine spotting Honey there, kicking her away, going for the cover. Will that be enough? Just a kick to the chest? No, but it is enough to keep Honey seated. Now Honey resting there, dazed. Unable to block out. A block away from the elbow drop is Catherine displaying her dominance. Going for a suplex. And gets it. And more of a brainbuster, I suppose. that baseball bat shot earlier. That does a lot more damage. Speaking with the baseball bat, is that what Honey's going for, or is she going for something new? She's just taking a breather. Nope, she's going for something new, and here comes Catherine. Catherine, Honey finding a table, utilizing it to slide Catherine away. Now Catherine with the table herself. Surprisingly, Catherine not interested in using it. Honey real determined to keep that table active here. Surprisingly, rather than dropping Catherine on top of the table, she chooses to drop her on top of the ropes. Oh, there we go. Honey dropped on top of the table herself. In the back of Catherine's head, hitting the table, and now Honey with that table still. Standing up in the corner. Again, rather than just pushing her to the table, oh, and Catherine launching Honey to the outside. Getting the harem member back up and tossing her back into the ring. And there we go. Catherine with a bit of a hiccup there. Center of the ring, pinfall cover. This could be it. And there we have it, Catherine Neville victorious. Seemed like a tomahawk-like chop to Honey's head there. Awesome. Back in the ring, but a series of glitchy problems in this matchup here. Even choices of replays, just counters and pinfalls. There we see it, the final nail sending Honey into the middle of the ring. Now Catherine Neville will be advancing into the finals of this tournament, the Snow Bunny tournament. We will be seeing Catherine once more. Just unnerving, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. Catherine Neville down to her, I guess, sparkle suit. Here we go. This is what she wanted. Queen Amazonia in all her Snow Bunny glory. Queen Amazonia, the odds-on favorite still here in the Snow Bunny tournament. She worked her way through Roxy Stevens and Ann Bailey. Final matchup, and then ran right through Riley, utterly destroying the poor girl. And Catherine fares a little better. find out here in the finals of the Snow Bunny Tournament. There we go. Look at all that light. And Amazon is starting off with her trademark DDT. It looks like Catherine is at least ready for it. Trying for... Nope. So she's trying for a DDT herself, which is risking a suplex, and it pays off. Catherine with some hard hits, and this is a no-holds-barred contest. This sort of contest that certainly favors Amazonia, but I don't exactly see anything favoring her now. Catherine hitting the ropes, and DDT! Looks like Amazonia was trying for a backdrop, but no, Catherine Neville counters that. And now she is definitely feeling it. To the chest and sending Amazonia to the ropes. And now sending her up. No. No, sending her back inside. And now going for the cover. Oh, nice cover there. Catherine just. Man, just not certain what's going on with the VixXxen matches. They're definitely getting worse and worse. Putting in some weight, and now here we see Amazonia going to be doing what she does best. That is obliterate the opposition. But no, Catherine Neville, not one to say die. Catherine Neville stopping and now up on the apron. Whatever reason, it is that one area where VixXxen's having the most problems. At least they had a Catherine Neville in the Honey Rydel fight. Catherine just really, really working over Amazonia's face. Catherine tripping over nothing. And just to take Amazonia down. And again, this is no holds barred matchup. There's no count outs and no rope breaks. Hard shot there. Final nail. Is Catherine Neville going to become the Snow Bunny? No, she's not done. Amazonia crawling her way towards Catherine. Surprisingly, Catherine has been doing very well here in this contest. I would say that things are changing, but no, Catherine Neville now. Not giving Amazonia a chance. Amazonia now going for the torture rack. Catherine Neville locked into the torture rack. She's not giving up. Elbow to the ribs. Torture rack of Amazonia is certainly a dangerous maneuver. Catherine Neville finding her way out. And now countering back out, elbows to the top of the head. And Catherine trying to kick out Amazonia's back, but Amazonia just powers through it. And again, Catherine desperate with her assault. Not wanting to give Amazonia an inch. Staying directly on top of her. Gotta be running amok. Now another shot. Backdrop. Amazonia dropped on top of her head. Will this be enough? Two. And three. Yes! Catherine Neville victorious here tonight. Catherine Neville. The Snow Bunny. Whassup Wrestling's Snow Bunny. She came here with one objective. Get to Amazonia and defeat her. And she's done it all while trying to be humiliated by the council. Now Catherine Neville with perhaps the only accolade in Whassup Wrestling that, well, anyone else would want. I doubt anyone would want to go up to Catherine and say congratulations on being a snow bunny. We'll see you next time, ladies and gentlemen, for real Whassup Wrestling action.